I'm going to show you how to set up this craps simulation in an Excel spreadsheet. The green line shows the results of 400 pass bets, and the blue line shows 400 pass bets with taking maximum odds, 3x, 4x, 5x. So starting from a blank spreadsheet, I'll put the pass bet size here, 5. I just click there, type 5. And underneath, I'll type the labels die 1 and die 2. And underneath that, I'll put in a formula to randomly choose a die value from 1 to 6. So I'll say equals random left right enter. That's equal rand left right. And that generates a random number between 0 and 1. Now if I click on the little green dot, I can drag that down and make copies of that, and you see that each one has the same function in it, but generates a different random number. Now, if I go to this formula, it generates a random number between 0 and 1. To make it a number between 0 and 6, I'll multiply that number by 6. And to get a whole number instead of a fraction, I'll use the truncate function, T-R-U-N-C, left, and then right. That will throw away the fractional part and just have the whole number part. And that will result in a number between 0 and 5, a whole number between 0 and 5. So we want 1 through 6, we have to add a 1 to that. So I type plus 1, press enter. That's the function to use. And then I can copy that down. And here we get a different number between 1 and 5. I can copy this function, control C, click here, control V. Same function, I can drag this down. Now I've got two dice, and the throw is just the sum of those two numbers. Throw, say equals this cell to the left plus this cell. Enter, 5 plus 4 is 9. Similarly for the other rows, 6 plus 6 is 12, and so on. So how do you decide whether this wins or loses? This is the pass bet, so 7 or 11 wins. And 2, 3, or 12 loses. 2, 3, or 12. Now how do we make a function to do that? I'll make a logical function equals logical or this value equals 7, comma, or that same cell equals 11, right? Okay, let me make this column bold. I click the home and then bold. Okay, let me copy this function down. We never got 7 or 11. Let me press F9 a few times. They say 11, it's true. 7 is true, and so on. Okay, it's working as I expect. Now I'm going to modify this function here. First of all, I want to make this definitely column C, because I'm going to copy this later, and I want to always want to refer exactly to column C. That's our throw. Press enter. We should get exactly the same thing. True, false, and so on. 11 true, okay. Now I want to take this function, multiply it by the value in this cell, the amount of your pass bet. That's dollar sign A, dollar sign 1, always that exact cell, A1. Press enter. Press F9 a few times. So you see whenever you throw 7, you win 5. And when you throw 11, you win 5. That's working as we expect. Okay, now I'm going to copy this function from this cell to this cell and modify it. Here, we're looking not for 7 or 11, but 2 or 3 or dollar sign C4 equals 12. So now we're looking for any of these, this or this or this, 2, 3, or 12. And since this is a loss, I'm going to multiply this by minus 1 times minus 1. Enter. Okay. Copy this down. Now you see whenever you throw a 2, 3, or 12, you got a minus 5 in this column. Okay. Now what about throwing the point? What happens when you throw a point? Well, throwing 4 or 10 is pretty much the same. 4 or 10. And what happens when you throw a 4 or 10? You bet 3x, that's the maximum odds bet. And if you win, it pays 2 to 1, 2 colon 1. This is just a label. I'll make it wider so it can fit. And how do we set that up? First of all, I'll copy this cell from here to here. This is a test for the throw being not 7 or 11, but 4 or 10. C4 equals 4 or C4 equals 10. Press Enter. That means whenever you throw a 4 or a 10, you should get a 5 here. Looks like it's working. Yep, a 10 here results in 5 here. Now I'm going to modify this function. What happens when you throw the point? You throw until you get a 7, or let's say you throw, the point is 4. You throw until you get a 4 or a 7. So I'm going to multiply this by a logical function. If random number is less than 1/3. Why 1/3? 1/3. If the random number is less than 1/3, because you have a 1/3 chance of winning and a 2/3 chance of losing. So if by random chance, 1/3 of the time, you win, you get paid 7 bets. Why 7? You've bet 3 bets and it pays 2 to 1. That's 6 bets. Plus you win your original pass bet. That's 7 bets. What if you lose? You lose your 3x odds bets plus your original bet. That's a loss of 4. So I'll put a minus 4 there. Minus 4. Put a right parenthesis. Okay. Press Enter. Okay, let's see what happens. I'll copy this down to all these cells. Now, whenever you throw it a 4 or a 10, you're going to either win 35 or lose 20. Let's see if that works. And it should. You should win 1/3 of the time and lose 2/3. There's a 4. You lose 20. 10, lose 20. Try that a few more times. Yeah, lose 20. Win 35. Okay, it seems to be working. Now similarly for 5 or 8, the odds bet is 4x, and the payoff if you win is 3 to 2. So I'm going to copy this function, paste here, modify it for this point, 5, I made a mistake, it should be a 9 there. 5 or 9. Let's see. Instead of 1/3, the chance of winning is 2/5. 2/5. If you win, it's 7 because you're betting 4x. It pays 3 to 2, that's 6x. Plus your original bet is 7. If you lose, you lose 4x. Plus your original bet, past bet, that's minus 5. Okay, let me correct this label. 4 or 10. 5 or 9. Okay, let me check this again. If C4 equals 5 or 9, and if random is less than 2/5, you win 7 bets or lose 5 bets. That seems right. Copy. Now we're looking for throwing a 5 or 9 over here. Here's 5 is thrown and it loses 25. And here 5 is thrown again, it wins 35. Seems to be working right. Throw a 9 minus 25, 5 minus 25. Okay, same thing for this column. Okay, then if a 6 or 8 point is thrown, 6 or 8, the odds bet is, maximum odds bet is 5x, and the payoff on the payoff ratio is 6 to 5. Let's copy this function, Control C, click Control V, modify it. We're now looking for 6 or 8. The odds of winning is 5/11. 5/11. If you win 6 to 5 on your 5x, which is 6 bets, plus your original bet, that's 7 bets. If you lose your 5x bets, plus your original pass bet, that's a minus 6. There's the formula. Press Enter. Let's copy this down. Now when you throw a 6 or an 8, you should either lose $30 or win 35. Let's try that a few times. Yes, 6 or 8, yes, seems to be working. All right then, what is your win? It's simply the sum of these columns here. Only one of these columns will have a number, the rest will be all zeros. So say equals this cell plus this cell plus this cell plus this cell plus this cell, enter. So this cell is E4, F4, G4, H4, I4, the sum of these columns. Let's drag this down. So whatever number is active in this column gets in here, the zeros are ignored. Now what is your running total or your bankroll? Let's start with a bankroll of zero. I'll enter in this cell. And your bankroll is simply your previous bankroll plus the result of the current bet. Enter. So it's just the cell above plus the cell to the left. So as you win or lose, you lose 30. You win 35, you're at 5. You lose 30, minus 25, you win 5. It's minus 20 and so on. That's pretty much the whole simulation. Here's your final result after 10 bets. You can press F9 and see how far behind you are after 10 bets. In the next video, I'll expand it to 400 bets and graph it, and also show the results of just the pass bet without taking odds.